Hello everybody and welcome to this tutorial. I'm just gonna pick off from where I left off in the previous one. Anyway, in the previous one, as the last part, I've posed a question and you should have answered it before you started listening to this tutorial. In any case, as I said before, you have a type of proxy here and you always want to be using SOX 5. You don't want to be using HTTP because they're not really that safe. And SOX 5 doesn't support a lot of options. Anyway, this is the IP address of the proxy server. We will enter a few of them manually later on. And this here is the port number on which the proxy server is listening, the port that is open. And over here, these two words, now some proxy servers, especially paid ones, will always have a username and a password, so you can just type them here in plain text, unfortunately, but it is assumed that only you and you alone have access to this computer. And besides, this file is not everybody can read this file anyway, so if you just type in the username here and password here, you will gain access to a certain proxy that you have chosen or that you have paid for. Anyway, these are just examples. We won't actually be using these proxies or anything of a kind. We need to go down below. And here is the end of the file. So if I just press enter a couple of times, there we go. So there is only one proxy active at the moment. It's SOX 4. And all traffic is being routed here. So our Tor, it says defaults set to Tor. Now Tor by default listens on this port. And our connections will be going through Tor now, but just in case I want to add SOX, and you should really do this, SOX 5, press tab and type in exactly the same IP address. By the way, this 127.0.0.1, this is the loopback address of your computer, so this is for inter-device communication. And if you ping this address, it means you're pinging yourself basically. And usually people ping this address in order to make sure that the IP protocol is set up correctly, even though they don't have internet connectivity. So let's just type in 127.0.0.1, same port number, space here, no tabs, 9050. There we go. Press Control O to save a file, press enter. And by the way, you don't need to use Nano to edit this file. You can also use VI or some other text editor in order to edit it. I like using Nano. It's practical and it's fairly simple. It's a lot simpler than VI. I know how to use VI as well, but it's a bit more complicated, so I prefer to keep it out of tutorials. Anyway, do Control O to save, as I've done just a moment ago. Doesn't hurt. You can press it as many times as you like. It doesn't really matter. And then press Control X to exit. There we go. Now we have the file saved. Clear the screen. For you always want to make sure that you are working in a very neat environment, so to say. Then go ahead and type in service Tor status. See if Tor is running. Tor is not running, so it gives you an answer. And what we want is to start Tor up. So service Tor start. Press enter. There we go. Now the Tor service has started and it is up and running. So the next thing that we need to do is use proxy chains in combination with our Tor and in combination with our internet browser in order to be able to access a third party in order to verify that all is working properly and that we are anonymous. A lot of people do the configuration and they type in service Tor start and yeah, that's it. They don't verify the settings. They start the scan and what happens? Of course, they get detected because they most likely misconfigured something. So that's really a bad idea. What you want to do is go ahead and type in proxy chains. So proxy chains. Now this is you do not want to browse the internet as root. We're just going to use it to verify our proxy chains settings, and I'm going to close the web browser. So I'm just using it for that purpose. And we will use proxy chains later on for a different kind of purpose, for scanning and so on and so forth, and then we can use it as root. But for a browser, it's not a good idea for security reasons. Anyway, proxy chains, and then type in Firefox, or you can type in any favorite browser that you have. I think Firefox works the best with proxy chains, as that is the default browser of Kali Linux. Even though it says IceWeasel, it's Firefox, trust me. So type in proxy chains, Firefox, and we can type in the website that we wish to visit. So let's just type in www.duckduckgo.com. Now DuckDuckGo is one of those search engines that is also anonymizing you. So they do not record your IP addresses. This is a very nice feature that they have, and I definitely recommend using it, primarily because you have a far greater extent of anonymity than you do when using Google or an equivalent popular search engine, as they do record your traffic, they do record your IP addresses, and that can be problematic in itself, especially when you're doing some sort of footprinting. You do not want to be recorded anywhere. Anyway, let's just go ahead and press enter. And the web browser is loading. You can see that the loading time is definitely not the fastest. It's a bit slow, but it has loaded it up. We'll just go ahead back to our terminal and see. Excellent. So you see that the link has been established here. There are some problems, as it says denied somewhere, but that's okay. You're bound to encounter errors here, a ton load of them, especially when you're using custom chains. You will see there will be more error messages then there will be okay messages such as this one. But believe it or not, the connection still manages to pass through somehow, and it still manages to function in spite of that. Anyway, let's just go back and open up our web browser once again. And you can use pretty much a lot of services out there to do this sort of thing. So just type in check for DNS leaks and press enter. Wow, this was fast. Okay, so DNS leak test, excellent. Let's go ahead and click there and see what happens. Hello, this is my public IP address now, 217.13.197.5, and it says that I am from Germany. I assure you, I am not from Germany. If you want to verify all of this, you can open up a new terminal and type in service store stop, and then open up your regular web browser without the proxy chains command. Do the same test again, and you will see that you will get a completely different IP address, which will be your real IP address. So anyway, it says, hello, this is me from Germany. I'm going to do a standard test. I'm not going to do an extended test. Same thing, pretty much. This one does more rounds, but you get the same information, more or less. So it goes, query one, excellent. This is my IP ISP provider. So look, this is what they have concluded in regards to my DNS. It's level 3 communications, and it says country United States. Makes no sense of whatsoever. So I am anonymous now. I can't be detected, which is a very good thing to have indeed. Now this IP address will change from time to time. Let's just go ahead. Okay, if you remember 217.13, let me just copy it, and I'm gonna go ahead and show you that it actually does change. So accessories, I'm pretty sure I have a text editor here. Excellent. So I'm just gonna paste this IP address, and now what I'm going to do is go ahead and close this browser, and don't need this. So service tour stop. Stopping it, service tour start, it's starting it. So you don't need to write actually stop start, you can also do service tour restart, and it's gonna do the whole process for you, so you can save a little bit of time there. And let's just repeat everything and go ahead, and I'm just gonna go ahead and type in proxy chains Firefox, and I will request the same search engine as well. Will it open? Now, don't be discouraged if it doesn't open it straight away, if it says, okay, you don't have connectivity or the website is not available or something of a kind. Just try typing in service space store space restart command a couple of times over again until you get it. Because sometimes certain IP addresses are blocked and you need to be assigned the one that is not. So just don't immediately jump to a conclusion, oh, it's broken, oh, what am I gonna do? It's gonna take forever to fix this, how am I gonna do this? No, just try resetting it a couple of times and you will resolve the problem, primarily because a different IP address will be assigned to you. So anyway, let's just go ahead and type in again, check for DNS leaks, press enter, and here we go. I'm just going to use the same website. It's DNS leak or whatever. DNS leak test, that's the name of it. Excellent. So you see now, I don't even need to compare the IP. Obviously, it's different. So this one is 217.13. This one is 91.109. So completely different IP address here. And from a completely different place. Now it says that I am from United Kingdom, apparently somewhere in London. I'll just go ahead and issue a standard test to see what sort of resolutions will I get here. This might take a while. Usually, that's why I'm doing the standard test, because it's a lot faster. But you see, the last one was rather fast. This one is a bit slower. Depends on the distance. I suppose I'm a bit closer to Germany than I am to the United Kingdom. I don't know. I suppose this depends on the speed of the servers as well. Anyway, you can see my DNS resolutions here. It's level 3 communications. Again, I have stated nothing from United States. Yeah, I am completely anonymous with this, not likely to be detected by pretty much anything. Just to give you an example, if you wanted, for example, to use ProxyChains with Nmap, I'm not going to go into great detail now. I will show you this when we get to the Nmap section. But before we do, you can see some verbose output here, how this is actually functioning. So there are certain domains which are being contacted. You can see pretty much everything that is going on here. No problems. Not a bad idea to sometimes go through this sort of information, especially if you do not have connectivity or you wish to understand better exactly where is your traffic going, where it is ending up, and how is it spinning around. Anyway, let's just go ahead and clear the screen and use, let's say, ProxyChains and Nmap. And this is all that you would need to do in order to route all of Nmap's traffic through ProxyChains. This is pretty much true of any application. Just invoke the application as you would. So normal Nmap invocation would be Nmap and then some IP address here and then a port number here and some arguments as well to go along with it. But instead of just typing it like that, you can use ProxyChains and hide yourself. Also, you just type in, how would you invoke a browser on a regular basis? You would type in Firefox, press enter, and that would of course open up a Firefox browser. So any application that you can start through your terminal, and you can start all of them through your terminal, just type in ProxyChains in front of it and all the network information generated by that application will be routed through your current, through the ProxyChains. Now, will it use a preset of proxies or will it use Tor? That is up to you how you have configured it. And there will be a part 3 to this. I will show you how can you import custom chains of proxies and how you can use those proxies to access things on the net or to hide your activity behind them. In any case, I bid you farewell and I thank you for watching.